Hello, good evening, happy Thursday. Welcome to Rogue Legacy. I don't have a fancy name for this stream, like Thursday Night Rogue Explosion or anything like that, because I'm probably just going to be playing this one game, because I really like it a whole lot. I've been playing it quite a bit, not streaming it. I beat the first boss, and I unlocked quite a bit of the skill tree here. Still have a lot that I need to fill out. Hello to the chat room. Shoutouts to Galen, Just Drop, Bippo, and Kostya. How are all of you tonight? So yeah, I did start a separate profile. I was going to go back to my old profile that I streamed with last time for the purposes of the stream, but I figure I can treat it like I treated the Binding of Isaac, where, you know, I don't need to stream all of my progress in the game, just, you know, just doing a run, you know, no matter what point in the game I'm at can be pretty entertaining. This game is kind of like the new Binding of Isaac for me. Like, this fills the void that the Binding of Isaac left once I, you know, got the Platinum God. Okay, so anyway, I'm a Barbarian Knight, which is the upgraded Barbarian. And I have, what do I have? I have, what's that word? Is it eidetic? Eidetic? I'm not 100% sure. Memory. Remember enemy placement. And for the first time so far, I'm ambilevis, which means spells come out of my back instead of my front. So I can fire daggers at the training dummy out of my butt. And I noticed recently that the name of the training dummy changes every time you hit it up at the top there. Wait, what did that say? Oh. Is thou even what? Moist? Huh. Oh, well, anyway, I have 246 gold, which isn't enough to afford anything right now. Eidetic. I guess that's how it's pronounced. If you miss Binding of Isaac, you can still play it. Yeah, but I don't have anything left to do in it. I got everything and 100%ed all of it, so I'm pretty much done with that game. I got the upgrade where I only have to give Charon 96% of my gold instead of all of it. So yeah, I've beat the first boss, as you can see in the door there. I haven't really messed with, you know, exploring much of the castle after this section. I'm assuming that the next section I should try is the forest. That's what the journal entries kind of seem to indicate. They make it sound like the forest is the next area I should go to. I did mess around a little bit in the Maya before I got that journal entry. That gives me that impression, and the Maya is pretty difficult. Also, the game gets a lot more difficult as you level up. Like, you know, the same parts get more difficult. Definitely scales with you, the difficulty in this game. Oh, Lord Tamar, what's up? And welcome back, Just Drop. With face sustenance for stomach fulfillment. You know, that's my favorite kind of sustenance. So yeah, I'm just going to die a lot and have a good time. Hope that's okay with all you guys. That's kind of how these games go. Moores did a pretty cool stream in this game the other day, where he beat the boss of the dungeon, which is, I'm assuming that's, you know, that's intended to be the last boss you fight. And I watched him do that, and that was pretty good. Did get a little bit of you know, strategy advice that I may or may not put to good use when I end up getting there eventually. And then he went on to fight, trade the dagger for the chakram? Sure, why not? And then he went on to fight the actual last boss of the game, which I stopped watching at that point because, you know, spoilers. You know, I don't want too much outside information about this game. Moore's moves so damn fast. Yeah, it's a little stressful watching him play, but it worked pretty well for him. Missy Shea, what's up? Dying is the best time, says Bippo. I agree. Dying is fun. Was that water? I don't think I've ever seen water in a castle level before. That's weird. I wonder if I can actually go that way. So yeah, I don't move quite as quickly as Moore's. I tend to be a little bit more methodical. Doing okay so far. I do have a little bit of vampirism going on, so I can get health back at a slightly faster rate than normal. Also, I've been finding a lot of chicken this time around. I had a pretty lucky run like that the last time as well. That looks like a lot of enemies. That's a lot of red dots. I like the fact that these blue guys, the ice shards, normally they can't go through walls unless they're right up against the wall. It seems inconsistent to me. I go slow, then again I usually play Spelunker. I haven't unlocked the Spelunker yet, but I do like using the Miner. I mean, I wouldn't want to like do a boss run as the Miner, but for just normal, casual playthroughs where, I mean, I'm basically just grinding for gold at this point. I mean, it's not really a grind since I do enjoy it and it's fun, even when I'm not intending to fight a boss. But my main reason for playing at this point is to get gold and unlock more upgrades. I mean, that's kind of the progression of the game. So mine is fun for that. I think my favorite class right now is the Lich, which I have upgraded to the Lich King. I like being the Lich King, and then equipping all of the vampirism upgrades, because the items that give you vampirism all make you start with less health than normal. I think it's minus 30 health for each one you equip. But the Lich King, his max HP goes up for every enemy he kills. So, I equip all of the vampirism items, and I'm getting, 9 or 10 health every time I kill an enemy, because I have the vampirism, two vampirism runes equipped now as well. So, they combo pretty well together. Hey, what's up, Kibitz? I could try to fight the boss again just to show it off. However, I would really like to have a character who has a peripheral artery disease. I didn't know what that did the last time I streamed, but I kind of suspected that it had something to do with the spike traps. And I was correct. When you have peripheral artery disease, then the spike trap can't detect your pulse and you don't trigger the spikes, which is super useful for fighting at least the first boss. Well, at least the first and the fourth boss. So yeah, if I do get a character with peripheral artery disease, I might go back and fight the first boss again. Mostly just because, it's good money. And it shouldn't hurt me too much if I have a good upgrade when I fight it. Oh, you can't refight the bosses? Oh, that's weird. Wonder if anything happens if I try to go through that door. I haven't actually tried it. I kind of assumed you could. Well, that's kind of a bummer. That means I can't show off that boss. Nope, nothing happens. Oh well. I have a different thought on the best choice of runes for the Lich. Well, I haven't unlocked a lot of the runes yet, so I mean, there could quite possibly be a much better strategy with the Lich that I just haven't found yet. I haven't unlocked a lot of stuff in general yet. Like, even though I've been playing for like 7 hours at this point. which doesn't feel that good. Morris has been playing the game for about 11 hours total, and he's ready to beat the game. And at 7 hours, I've only fought the first boss. Shit. Because I do stuff like jump directly into fireballs. You know, good times. Is there even a reason for me? Oh, yeah. Okay. Alright, Chess, your story checks out. Morris also doesn't use the double jump or any of the dash runes, which, you know, I've come to rely on those so much, I don't know if I could give them up at this point. All gold runes on Lich. Yeah, I haven't gotten any gold runes yet. At least I don't think. Man, I came across a real dick move in this game. Playing it the other day, I found this giant painting at one point that shows you, like, it's like a little thing from the developer about one of their previous games, and it gives you some history and stuff about the game. And I came across another one of those giant paintings, and I thought, oh cool, it's another little piece of lore. But no, it turned out to be one of the paintings that attacks you, and it's really big, and it did like 3/4 of my health in one hit. So yeah, well played, Cellar Door Games. I'm all about upgrading my castle. I suck. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much where I am at this point. You know, I have done a few of the challenge rooms, but I also failed a lot of them as well. And when I do get a challenge room, I don't usually bother using the architect to try it again. Because my reasoning is I'm sure I'll find that room again eventually, and any time that I spend grinding that room is just wasted time, because because I only get 40% gold. So I'd rather just do, you know, full gold runs and try it again when I get back there naturally. Alright, this is a little mini game you can do every now and then. Oh, this is different than the other one. There's one where you have to throw axes to hit targets, and you get 5 axes. I'm not sure what this is. Oh wait, no, this is it. Okay, never mind. It said you only get 1 shot, so I thought it would be something different. Yeah, I'm really bad at this. Is this still gonna come out of my butt? Probably. I better, I'll stand in the middle, so either way, I'm in good shape. Yep, still out of the butt. If you get, if you have less than 10 targets remaining at the end, then you get a special prize, and I don't know what it is because I've never done it. That's not bad. Oh wait, I have one more. Wow, I might actually do it this time. Witness the power of the butt. Alright. And I got an achievement. Alright, what do we get? Bloodhelm. Oh man. All of the blood items give you the vampirism stat at a minus 30 health penalty. I mean, that's good if I want to do, you know, full lich vampirism, but I don't know. Anything else to say? No. Well, screw you too, guy. Galen says she rarely locks the dungeon. Yeah, I mean, if I'm like practicing against a boss and I can just teleport straight there, then I'll do it that way, since it's not really a waste of time. But I mean, if it's a challenge room that I have to make my way back to every time, oh god. Alright, see if I can. Oh shit, apparently not. Great. I was going to say, let's see if I can hit that thing with a chakram, but it did not work. Well, probably no reason for me to smash those tables and chairs and stuff. Not worth the risk of getting hit anyway. Crap! Aw, man. The painting thing didn't reset when I left the room. I thought all the enemies reset their positions. I've taken a lot of damage in the last couple rooms. crap. Saw it coming. Did not dodge in time. Crap! Even when I don't have the OCD trait, I still kind of compulsively smash everything. Whoa! It's the first time I found a stat boost just in a random chest like that. Plus, you're losing out on chests you've already opened when you lock the dungeon. Yeah, exactly. I mean, the best way to get money is to just go through and open all the chests. And, you know, when the dungeon's locked, most of those chests are, you can't open them twice. I think there are chests that actually reset, though. Yeah, great. I'm gonna have to go up this way. Alright. Nope. Wow, this sucks. Is there any other way for me to go? Well, I can go. Well, yeah, I'll just hit that teleporter. I should have done that to begin with. Alright, well, there's really only one more big area two, I guess, in the castle. So let me just finish filling out the castle, and then I'll move on to the forest, which I still haven't really explored that much, so it should be pretty interesting. Aw, man. I hate these rooms where they're enemies you can't kill. I mean, I could kill them if I had, axes, I guess. Or the crows. No, like, secret way for me to drop down there, is there? No, sometimes there is. If I was a dwarf, I could go up through that little passageway, but I'm not. Even when I know I've already thoroughly been through a room, I still slash at the paintings, just to be sure. Alright, new journal entry. Scour the tower. So yeah, looks like the, oh crap. Looks like the preferred order is castle, forest, tower, dungeon. Is that big painting going to, I guess not, since I already slashed at it. I was really worried that the clown would attack. You should use the Barbarian King action skill on those fast wall turrets when you try to climb near them. Yeah, that's a good idea. I actually didn't know the Barbarian Shout had any effect on the turrets. I thought it was just the enemies that could actually move. Alright, is that the whole... Is that everything in the castle? Yeah, it looks like... Well, crap. Well, that room over... Eh, screw it. Good enough. I doubt there's anything worthwhile over there. And, you know, I really want to move on to something different since my last stream was... What is that? I guess it's just part of the background. That little glowy purple thing. But yeah, my last stream was entirely within the castle, so I'd like to move on to something different. This does seem easier than the Maya so far. Deflects. Oh, it breaks and deflects projectiles. Oh, okay. Good to know. Yeah, those purple things are just background. Okay. Digging the music for this area. Very kind of down tempo and creepy. I hate these shield guys. If you hit them in the shield, then you get knocked way the heck back. But sometimes you're not in a good position to hit them any other way. And also hitting them in the shield barely does any damage to them. Like, I was fighting shield guys in the Maya who took like 20 hits to kill. It was pretty obnoxious. But I guess I wasn't supposed to be there yet. Oh, wow. That was a pretty good, path for that thing. Because when you kill those guys, their spiky balls fly off in whatever direction they are currently swinging. So, that one had a perfectly horizontal trajectory. That's the word I was looking for, trajectory. Oh god. Oh crap. Alright, don't want to jinx myself. I'm actually doing pretty well this run. I think this is the most gold I've ever gotten on one single run. Alright, let's test this barbarian shout theory. Huh? Yep, it worked. Man, I fought a big version of those spitting plants. Well, that was in the last frame, wasn't it? There were like two of them. That was a pain in the ass. Nope. Not low enough. Also, these guys don't take nearly as many hits or knock you back nearly as far as the shield guys in the Maya did. Ow! Wow. That's a lot of damage for being spikes. You can slash the roots on the ceiling too. Oh, like for items? Oh crap, I didn't know that. Wait. Oh. In the castle there, you occasionally came across these fountains that heal you for a whole lot and give you a lot of mana back. But I guess that's just a decorative fountain. No restorative properties. Also, the Maya had it had some of the mimic chests that some people referred to in the last stream. Oh god, there it is. The two plants. Actually, these don't seem as bad as the ones I fought last time. Still hurt though. Crap! Oof. Man, maybe I don't want to bother with that. It was Sudmores. No, I haven't actually made it to the second boss yet. Right now I'm just kind of going through and, you know, getting my bearings, collecting some money. Crap! Taking some damage. The nice thing about the double jump and the air dash is that you can equip multiple versions of the runes in different equipment, and you can air dash or double jump, you know, multiple times depending on how many you have equipped, which can be really helpful with some of the challenge rooms. I haven't seen any roots that I can slash. Let me know if I pass any up. Man, I'm so jealous of his last stream. Freaking two blood items as early as he got them is ridiculous. Really? I didn't realize that was a big deal. Actually, I've gotten two more blood items since then. Oh man, well, here's the boss. Don't know if I'm quite ready to try it yet, though. Yeah, that's a lot of bouncy things. You know what I say to that? Well, I guess that doesn't really affect them. Well, that's a pisser. I mean, I would try to fight the boss if I had, you know, full health at this point. But I think it would be kind of a fool's errand at this stage. I should just try to maximize my goal for this run, which is already pretty good. Oh, man. Are those things heads on fire, or are their heads just fire? Hmm. I don't like this. I think they're just fire. Alright. This isn't... Ah, crap. I say as I jump into the fireball. Ah, crap. I would really like their chests. Yeah, I should lock the dungeon and give that boss a shot. Let's see. Ooh, Hokage. Oh, but it's Vertigo. Well, I don't know. That might actually be useful against the boss, since the spikes are on the floor. I don't know. It's a perpetual state of head orgasm, says Just Drop. Well, what the hell? I can always just lock the dungeon again. Alright, what am I going to spend all this money on? Well, oh, wait. The whole level flipped upside down, not just... Oh, crap. Well, kind of regretting that now. Oh, man, why did I do this? I thought it was just going to be my character who's upside down. Now, there's the blood helm. It's only 500 to unlock. Might as well. I don't want to actually use it yet. Oh, crap. I think I'm just going to lock the dungeon down and kill myself. And then do it all again. After I spend all this money. Alright. What about you? Any good runes I can buy? Man, I can't even read this. Okay, that's another one of the jump runes. That's the, oh, I have to hit down. That's the balance rune. Or the, no, that's the grace rune. See, everything's upside down and backwards. Which makes it easier to read if you look at it one way, but if you look at it another way... Sky rune. Oh, crud. Okay. I think I'm just going to buy some of these upgrades. Cause I know what these... I mean, these are all, you know, right side up. Let's see. Well, I can always build out and get more of the castle. Upgrade my miner to a spelunker. Or what's the other upgrade? Upgrade spell thief. I haven't even used a spell thief yet. Flight rune. Allows you to hover. How much did they want for that? Let's see. But I'd have to give up one of my vampirism runes. Wait, is that 5? No. That's 1575, right? Yeah. Yeah, okay. I think. Did I just spend 4,000 on that? Oh, no. Okay, I'm good. Alright, health and damage, that's where your money should be going. Well, I mean, on the one hand, you know, I agree with you, but on the other hand, like, I didn't unlock stuff like... I mean, there might be more stuff to unlock that I still need to get. And, you know, I really just want to get the whole skill tree. Bippo likes Spell Thief, Moors hates Spell Thief. Well, let's see. Can I get this and upgrade my miner? I think I can. I mean, I can always get the money back, right? Yeah. See, if I didn't unlock that, I wouldn't have unlocked this. I don't know what that is. Oh, invulnerability time. Although I guess that's like frames of invulnerability when you get hit. And I wouldn't have unlocked this. Mana cost down. See, that's super useful. So now I should do this. Oh, I can't afford that. Okay. I would not listen to Moors on that one. Yeah. I mean, I'm going to get the whole tree eventually. I might as well do it, you know, as soon as possible. Oh, what the hell? Okay. Kind of wish they would have gone with a different name for that one, but okay. Magic blows ass in this game. Yeah, exactly, because you did not upgrade it, like cost says. And with the rest of my money, I will get some health. Alright. Time to kill myself so I don't have to actually play like this. Remember to lock this thing down. Man, I've screwed myself so many times by forgetting to lock the castle down. Alright, let's make this quick. Hate to have to do this, but... yeah, I feel a little nauseous just looking at this. I mean, not nauseous, but like, you know, uneasy. Fight the boss with this guy, though. Thanks. Alright, gay hypochondriac assassin. Low stats, but can land devastating crits. I'll try it as a pally. Wow, no money? That's weird. Why don't I have any money? Oh yeah, maybe I should equip that flight rune and see what it actually does. What was that on? My, well, since I'm fighting the boss, oh, it's already equipped. Press A while in the air to hover. Oh, interesting. So that comes after the double jump. Wonder if that's more or less useful than the air dash. I mean, having that and the air dash, well, I guess I can combo the two and get even more horizontal distance, right? Yeah. Alright. Well, I'll try it out for a little while. And then with this, I just have not much. Oh, crap. Oh, wait, I already did that. Okay. For a second, I thought I forgot to pay the guy. Like I usually do. Oh, you can control vertical movement with hover as well? Oh, interesting. So it's kind of a double jump combined with the air dash. Whoa! I broke it. In terms of maneuverability. Alright, well, I guess there's no point in opening those. Alright, well, let's see what this boss looks like. Kind of an underwhelming name for a giant pink floating skull head. Well, I might as well use this mana while I have it. This enemy actually has, or this boss actually has, enemies to fight as well as the boss. So vampirism would actually come in handy here. It wasn't useful at all for the first boss because obviously it was just the boss. Ah, crap. Well, I fell leap for a second. Ow. Kinda wish I had a more useful spell than the dagger. Like, the bouncing orbs would be pretty nice. Ah, crap. Wish those daggers flew out faster. Can't tell how low I had the boss because I keep seeing his minions' health. Out of mana. And I'm almost out of life. Oh man, I have him pretty low. Crap. Oh man. Ah, oh, crap. I panicked. Hello, Citron and Aggrold. If you combine vampire plus a target seeking birds, it's a breeze. Yeah, that would be a good combo. I felt like that was going okay. Ooh, Lich Queen. Well, minor. Well, let's try it again with the barbarian. One of the runes leeches both health and power on a kill. Yeah, I was using those for a while, but, this is fine. I was using the balance runes for a while, but, I decided 2 health per kill is better than 1 health and 1 mana per kill. At least for the kind of characters, you know, I was playing. Normal size this time, so won't be quite as easy to get hits in on the boss. That went better than I expected, though. Does not seem as, like, there's not as much ridiculous stuff flying on the screen as there was with the first boss. I mean, there's certainly some ridiculous stuff, but, I don't know, I feel like it's more manageable. Crap. Man, that floating ability is nice. Definitely glad I picked that up. Makes maneuvering around this boss way more doable. Aw, man. I thought it was too high for that thing to hit me. Pretty good music on this boss, too. You know, the music in this game, or some of it anyway, is done by the same guy who did the music in Binding of Isaac. Danny Baranowski, I think? Oh, crap. Maybe I should have saved some of my mana so I could do a barbarian shout. Because the skulls are definitely the thing that provide the challenge in this boss. I mean, if it weren't for the tiny skulls, Alexander himself wouldn't be, wouldn't be that hard. Ah, crap. I wasted all of my mana. Yeah, oh well. Hit enemies to restore mana. No, don't feel like that would be that useful against the boss. The chakra might be useful, but I don't really want to be a dwarf. I got 8, yeah. Alright, well, let's try it with, Let's try it with the barbarian again this time. Be more careful about what I use my shell on. has the sepia filter again. Dwarfism is awesome. Small hitbox. Yeah, that's a lot. That's also a lot harder to hit hit things with that tiny sword. Seems like I had more MP this time. I don't know, maybe not. I don't know. Oh well. Bosses are easier to dodge when small. Yeah, it's... I can't skip that. It's definitely a trade-off. Oh. Gonna use that right out the gate, huh? Save some of my mana. Oops, I should try hitting him with the shotgun though. See how many hits I can. Oh, that wasn't bad. Ah, crap. I think Barbarian plus equipping a lot of the vampirism items might be a good combo too, since Barbarians have so much health. Reminds me of a Binding of Isaac boss, actually, just the way it's structured. Ah, damn it. Not doing nearly as well this time. That big sword was definitely nice. Oops, wrong button. I meant to do that. Oh yeah, there we go. That was a sweet spot. Ah, crap. Okay, one more try and then I'll reset the dungeon and grind for a little bit more money. JVM Guerra, welcome. Ooh, Hokage. I was kind of hoping for the Hokage, actually. This is probably my favorite class in general. I mean, I like being the Lich King or Queen with a lot of vampirism, but just as... you know, as an all-purpose general class, the Hokage is definitely one of the better ones. They can't crit, but their damage is so high that it doesn't really matter. I wonder what happens if you lock the dungeon down after you talk to them. It's probably still okay. As long as you don't enter the dungeon before you talk to the architect. Alright, one more time. Alright, the Hokage ability is like a, it's like a flash, right? It's kind of a quick little horizontal teleport. Not the most useful thing in the world. See, right out the gate, huge chunk of health gone, but I took half my health and damage as well, so. Oh, that was fast. Alright, let's try one more. I feel like that could have gone better if I was more careful. Do I get another Hokage? No. Oh, upside down, fuck that. Aw, man, I hate the congenital insensitivity to pain, because you don't know how much health you have left. Alright, one more try, then I reset, because I know it's boring watching me fail the same thing over and over again. And if you can just come out the gate with the Hokage without taking much damage, I feel like that could be the way to go. Yep, my health bar is blank, so in a way I kind of like that because I'm not like stressing out about my health. I'm not like constantly looking at it and being like, oh crap, I only have 2 hits left. So, I did not jump that high, game. Because I think that was definitely a factor in the Hokage fight as well, because I looked up and I saw that my health was half gone and I kind of freaked out just a little bit. So yeah, like anything else in this game, it's a trade-off. I wish I had some crowd control. I don't really like the sword that much either. I don't know. I got a few good hits on this guy and with the sword, but in general, it's not my favorite weapon. Ah, crap. Oh, that didn't go too well. Alright, let's mess around some more. Yeah, I'll be the Hokage again. With orbs, too. Actually, Hokage with orbs might be... I don't know. It might be good against the boss. Okay, one more boss try. Since I'm the Hokage with orbs. Or the Hokage, as I called it before I realized I was pronouncing it like an idiot. Until I watched Moore's stream and he pronounced it, and oh yeah, it probably makes sense. Right, I need to remember not to touch these orbs. Still don't last as long as I would like, even when I don't touch them. Kinda wish they would bounce just a little bit longer. Oh crap. Oh god. Well, that's it for my mana. Maybe I should have waited till there were more skulls on the screen until I used the orbs. Oh well. See, I can take those skulls out in one hit with this guy, or this lady. Which makes clearing them out way easier. Of course, the trade-off is, I'm almost dead. Oh, wow. Well, I'm not almost dead. I thought I got hit way more than I did. Okay, well, see, Hokage. That's the power of it, I guess. Is this supposed to look like that, or is that a glitch? That's supposed to represent him being, like, petrified or something? Doesn't look quite right. Oh, so that's one of those roots. Okay, well, that went okay. Magic damage and armor. This thing didn't drop nearly as much gold as the first boss did, though. And it was a glitch, okay. That was weird. Alright, well, let's hear it for the Hokage. I guess I can check out the Maya now. It say the top three classes are Hokage, Spellsword, and Barbarian in that order, and the magic and physical stats are raised equally. Yeah, I haven't checked out the, oh, god damn it. I haven't checked out the Spellsword yet, but it seems like it could be cool under the right circumstances. Oh, crap. I hit it, revealed it as a mimic, and I still walked into it. WTG. Oh, god. Don't throw... Aw, oh, man. I was gonna say don't throw ninja stars at me, but... It was too late to have to worry about it. Alright, well, let's try out the spell sword. Stereo blind, but... I've had worse. I guess I did get a pretty good bit of gold from that boss. I mean, even with only getting 60% of it, still have enough to get an upgrade or two. Alright, well, let's get that. Plutophobia. Oh, level 50. Cool. Randomized children. Use the power of science to make a whole new batch of babies. Huh. See, that's interesting, because I find myself in situations pretty often where I don't like any of the choices. Now let's see, 1105. Don't think that's enough to buy any equipment or anything. Can't upgrade any anything on the edges. So yeah, I'll just get more armor. I haven't upgraded my armor that much. Whoa, I'm all sparkly. What effect is that? Oh, empowered spell. 30% of damage dealt is converted into mana. Huh. That's interesting. Okay, so how do I want to load myself out? See, I have all the blood items except for the, I guess these are bracers? Arm armor? Or are they just called limbs? I guess they're just called limbs. So if I equip all four of these, and, let's see, I have a vampirism rune on 1, 2, 3 of my, oh wait, I haven't actually bought this one yet, but theoretically, I could be getting back a lot of health for every enemy I kill. Spell swords are sparkling and clean. Yes, they are. Alright, nothing to dump this 375 gold into, so. You win this time, Charon. Alright, well, two bosses down. I actually wasn't expecting to beat a boss in during this stream, so. Happy with the way that worked out. Wow, 10 MP just for hitting that guy? That's cool. Of course, my damage is pathetic. But, you know, my scythe does... it's pretty respectable. If I had a better spell, then... that'd be pretty awesome. And more mana, preferably. I'm, like, at ultimate mobility, though. With my double jump, my air dash, and my hover. Oh god. Only problem with the hover is that you can't really cancel out of it if you wanna reduce altitude early. You just kinda have to remember to go down. Ah, damn it. Damn it! I was hoping I could hit that eyeball without having to land on the spikes. Okay. You're big. And you're dead. I Man, the spell sword with the ravens or the crows or whatever. That would be pretty nice. Wonder if there's an upgrade you can get that lets you, well, I guess when you re-randomize your characters, it re-randomizes their equipment too. But there's no way to, like, keep the spell sword and change what, or change what spell they start with. Not equipment, but their starting spell. Using magic a lot is a good idea. Yeah, I agree. Just going to have to remember to do that more. Take no damage. Ah, man, I hate these. Well, I don't hate them. If I had the Hokage, this would be really easy. Because I could just teleport past those fireballs. In fact, other than the Hokage, I don't know how you're supposed to do this. If it's even possible with any other character. Try the empowered spell. Oh. So that's just a better version of the spell you already have. Okay, that's cool. Doesn't help me with this challenge room, though. I mean, I know that's not what you meant. You didn't mean it would help with that, since the chat's, you know, behind where the actual stream is. Wow, that's a lot of damage. I can only imagine how much damage that would be with the ravens. Well, I was going to say, do I have any vampirism right now? I guess I have one vampirism rune equipped. Just a tiny dwarf, so my my sword isn't big enough to penetrate that box. Well, if I had more mana, I could use my scythe on some of these guys, but I don't. Spellsword can't get ravens? Aww. Well, that's a bummer. Can I get the orbs? Ooh, a jukebox. Nice. Get to sample some other music. There's a lot of music you could play with this thing, too. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16 different tracks you can play on the jukebox. I don't really know which one is the best. I like Pistol Shrimp. Any requests in the chat room? Otherwise, I'll probably just stick with this for a little while. I don't know if this is actually from the game or if this is from one of Cellar Door's previous games or what. It's pretty nice, though. Alright, I'll just stick with this. I didn't really leave the chat room enough time to make requests. Crap! But if anyone really has a request, then I'll go back and change it. It doesn't follow you out of the room. It doesn't follow you out of the area. Like, if I went to the forest, it wouldn't follow me there. But it sticks with you as long as you're in, as long as you're in the castle. Crap! That's me trying to remember to use my magic more and failing. Shut up. I hate how the paintings laugh when they turn into monsters. It's like, yeah, I know you're a monster. I can see you wiggling. Alright, someone requested the song Lamprey, so I will switch to that. There we go. Oh god. So do you get MP back when you hit a monster with a spell? No, I guess. Well, that makes sense, since you're a spell sword. Whoa. and got a medal on you for a second there. Oh god. Oh crap. I have to say, I'm kind of liking the spell sword. And being able to do that as frequently as I can. It's pretty nice. I just have to remember to use it. Pistol Shrimp is the boss theme for the first boss. Okay. Alright, well, don't want to go into the dungeon just yet. I'm just kind of, music reset. Oh well. I'll go back there on my way back, I believe. Yes. Doomvus. Get it? It's like a canvas, but it's Doom, I guess. It's not a very good play on words. I mean, I don't know if it was supposed to be a play on words, but I should have gone with the play on words. I'm trying to come up with something better, but I can't think of anything. Badvus? No. Oh, I give up. Nice, free chicken. Alright. Could just teleport back, but I want to hit that jukebox again. See what some of the other songs sound like. See, someone said they like the main theme. I'll switch to that. You mean just this? Just Rogue Legacy? Title screen music? That's a good one. Ooh. Didn't really have a good angle on that. Alright, I won't worry about the enemies that don't have projectiles. Since, well, I mean, I probably won't be going back through that room anyway. Ooh, more lore. Kinda wish there was an air dash that also let you attack in the middle of the dash. Like, you can sort of attack at the end of the dash, but not... Like, I want to fly through the air and just slice an enemy as I dash. Mega Man style. Might be something like that that I just haven't found yet. I mean, there are a lot of runes to unlock. I mean, I'm already technically halfway through the game. That I've beaten the first two bosses. And I've only unlocked like maybe seventh or an eighth of the runes. If that. Ah, damn you. Get me all out of rhythm. Indie games on average have better music than the big games. I mean, lately it seems like, you know, big AAA kind of games haven't really had memorable music. I mean, except for like stuff with licensed music like GTA and Saints Row and stuff like that, but I don't really count those. Now, the last like big budget AAA game with really great music that I can remember would be like Shadow of the Colossus. And that was a while ago. Aw, man, I bet there's going to be something up there if I climb all these barrels. I'm going to try to do this without breaking any of them. Oh, nice. Managed to do it without setting off any of the paintings either. That was cool. Bam! I mean, that's been like 10 years at this point. So I'm sure there's been something since then. The Persona games have pretty good music. But, I mean, there hasn't been a Persona game in a while either. I guess Persona 4 Arena probably has good music. I haven't really played it. Prowess? Is that deliberate? I don't think so. Should be Prowess, right? Or am I crazy? I tried to outthink the sword in my face once. Didn't go too well for me. So there's a trait called electrophobic, which means you're afraid of chickens. And I thought it was just like one of those joke traits that doesn't do anything, or nothing substantial. But it turns out that when you are electrophobic, occasionally one of the pieces of wall chicken will come alive and attack you. And you have to kill it before you can actually pick it up. It doesn't do much damage, but it basically does enough damage to counteract its own efficacy. Kingdoms of Amalur had a really good soundtrack. Yeah, I haven't played that one either. I mean, I would hope Kingdoms of Amalur had a good soundtrack with, you know, how much money that guy stole from the state of Rhode Island. Okay, I guess stole might be a little harsh, but, you know. He did not obtain the money through 100% honest means. That baseball player guy, I forget his name. Oh, crap. Wait, you're still alive? What? I thought he was dead. Went up to hit him again and his prone body took me out. In all fairness, he paid him back completely. Oh, did he? Okay. I didn't follow up on that story. Kurt Schilling, yeah, that's the dude's name. Alright, Vertigo, fuck that. Spellsword, I like the spellsword. I don't know if he would be as good with the dagger, though. Or I could be a paladin. I don't want to be a dwarf again. I will be Sir Jimmy, the spellsword. Tunnel vision and a dagger. Okay, what do I want to spend all this money on? Can't afford that yet. Could upgrade the miner, I guess. Yeah, I might as well. Fill this out as much as I can. Because I can't afford whatever that does, either, right? Half man, half something? Is that a swear word, or are they just blocking it because of spoilers? I can't think of a swear word with six letters. Dicker? Half man, half dicker. All awesome. I'm assuming that's what it is. Alright, upgrade the miner to a splunker. Now that spiffy light thing on your head actually does something. Not really. Okay. That's why to turn on your headlamp. Well, I mean, it might be useful in the dungeon. Because, I mean, the dungeon has low visibility. It's a secret, not a swear. Okay. Oh, yeah, I guess fucker does have six letters. And damn it. If you spell damn it as one word and not two. Well, I mean, it still has six letters, but if you spell it as two words, but there would be a space in there as well. Welcome to the chat room, our Savugle. I'm sorry if I butcher your name. I don't know what that is. Okay. Wait. I still have 590. Is that enough to get anything? I kind of doubt it. No. Okay. And nothing to buy from this guy. Nope. Nothing I can afford from this lady. It is kind of a bummer, the higher up in levels you get, the more money you have to waste. The spiffy light actually does do something, but it drains mana, making it useless. Oh, that's disappointing. Oh yeah, tunnel vision. It just makes it so those little indicators that show you when a projectile is coming don't pop up like they normally do. One of these days I'll remember to save those instead of just mindlessly slashing them. Since I mean, there's almost always a piece of chicken in one of them. Well, not almost always, but it's a pretty good chance of it. But it's just so hard not to slash stuff. You guys know what I mean, right? Alright, come on, Skelly. If I had an axe, I'd show you what's what. Boy, let me tell ya. Let's see what the upgraded version of the dagger looks like. Huh, just a big dagger. Kinda makes sense. Although it doesn't really look like a dagger. Doesn't a dagger usually have like... not a hilt, but like a handguard? I think there's a name for that that I'm forgetting. Like the guard that swords have on the hilt. I guess it's still a hilt. It's really more of a, looks more like a carving knife. You call that a knife? This is a knife. Ah! I ran the heck away from that fireball. It's a good strategy. If you see a fireball flying at you, you should probably run in the other direction. You know, don't sidestep it in the third dimension or anything like that. That's just crazy talk. Pommel, yes. That's the word. Thanks, Chestrap. Oh, man. You can pray for assistance at the statue, but sometimes it curses you, too. I don't know what any of the prayers or the curses do. Oh, Calypso's compass. Oh, does it tell you where the boss is? I guess, since it seems like it's constantly pointing in the same direction. Crap, did I hit that guy? Oh, the compass shows you a secret room. Cool. What exactly is the difference between a dagger, knife, and a dirk? Well, a knife is like, it's usually a one-sided blade, I think. That's the other difference. And a dagger has a two-sided blade and a pommel. And then a dirk, I think it's just like a really thin blade. I don't know. I'm not really an expert on knives or anything. Ah! I think a dirk is kind of like a stiletto. Not the shoe, but the stabbing thing. Although I guess a stiletto shoe can be a stabbing thing too, when applied correctly. Aww. Ha! I was out of mana, but then I got some mana. Oh no! Yeah, a dirk is like piercing, says Just Drop. Daggers are more secretive weapons, so I didn't know that was the intended effect. Alright, well, still on the right track for the secret room. This is exciting. I don't think I've ever found an actual secret room before. Oh, the compass is, actually changing directions now, which means I'm close, I believe. Ah! Alright. Ah, crap. I was really hoping that dagger would. Well, according to this, secret room should be right around here. How do I get to it? Do I have to downslash? I mean, is it beeping? Or is that just a weird sound effect? It'll point you towards the invisible door. How do you go through an invisible door? Press up? Or maybe it's, I was gonna say maybe it's in a room below this, but I don't know if there is a room below this. It'd be a lot easier if I didn't have an eye spewing fireballs at me. Down a room? Okay, well, I guess let's try going right here and then see if I can circle back around. Ooh, jellies. Ah! No, I don't think that sound effect is related to the compass. It's just a weird effect of the slash or something. Alright, looks like I can go down. But those fountains really remind me of something from Sonic and Knuckles. Oh wait. Looks like I need to go that way. Let's clear some of these enemies out first. Alright. I don't have to be a dwarf to get it, do I? Well, there's definitely no wall there. In that little spot. An invisible area only indicated by an exclamation point speech bubble. Huh. Aw, man. Look at the size of that thing. Ah! Oh good, they stay split even if you leave the room. That's good to know. If I die before I find whatever this is, I'm gonna be so pissed. Wait. Sage bracers, okay. And sky sword, wow. Those sound like two items I could get some use out of, potentially. Oh. I am becoming more proficient in clearing monsters. It's like this guy's inside my head. Blobosaurus Rex. Oh, I didn't even notice the name. That's pretty good. Ah! Alright, well, no point in digging around in the forest anymore. Unless I just want to collect some more gold. Which is probably the best move. I mean, even if I do go on to the Maya, I'm probably not ready. Well, then again, I thought I wasn't ready for the boss of the forest either. The Hokage proved to rule all. Speaking of ruling them all, sort of, I'm probably going to go see the new Hobbit movie tomorrow. I mean, not probably. I am. I don't know if I'm excited about it or not. I mean, I kind of like the first Hobbit movie. I mean, I like the old animated Hobbit movie, which is the real first Hobbit movie. But I like the first Peter Jackson movie, even if it was, you know, way too long. And there's no reason for them to split The Hobbit into three movies. I mean, I thought it dragged, but it was entertaining for the old eyeballs. But so far, the reviews of this one have been slightly more positive than reviews of the first Hobbit movie. Is this New Game Plus? Nope, not yet. This is just me exploring the basic game. Hello, Dark Bledina? No spoilers, I'm waiting until all three is released. Well, I mean, The Hobbit is kind of past the statute of limitation for spoilers. I mean, the book is 175 years old. That's an exaggeration, but... Although, I guess the movies do have stuff that weren't in the actual Hobbit book. I don't know where they're getting the extra material, because apparently, Peter Jackson doesn't have the rights to, the Silmarillion. Silmarillion, or whatever. Which is where I thought most of the extra stuff in the movie was coming from. It's kind of like expanded universe fiction for the Lord of the Rings saga, except it was actually written by Tolkien, of course. Oh, okay. This is a different one. I have daggers instead of axes. Oh, I can't get any closer? Well, that's a bummer. Ah! I didn't notice how many I had to hit because I was talking about The Hobbit. Nope. I get more daggers. This is the first time I've done this, so obviously I suck at it. Ah! Moving so fast. It's not even moving that fast. Nope. The axe one is fair, this one is just mean. You couldn't even hit 8 targets. Aw, you don't even give me money for that? What a ripoff. You know, I think I've decided I don't like clowns. I'm taking a stand on this one. I know that's a controversial stance, since so many people love clowns so much. That's a joke. I don't think I've ever met anyone who's not freaked out by clowns in some way. I never had a problem with clowns. I went to a circus at a pretty young age, so I guess I kind of got acclimated to them. And I never saw the movie It, which apparently has a large bearing on most people's opinion of clowns. I mean, you know, I don't love clowns or anything. They're not my favorite in the world, but I don't have a, oh god. Oh man. That was a lot of enemies. It comes around so rarely that you can't get used to it. Yeah, that was the first time I've gotten the dagger game. Alright, well, that went okay. Ooh. No, it's an ectomorph, though. Ooh, break stuff to restore MP. I like this guy. Alright, I want to do my Lich King with all vampirism strategy at least once. Alright, can't afford that. Can't afford that. I can get more Death Defy. Nah. Oh, wait. I need to go see what that new equipment I got is. Nice. I don't have enough weight for it yet. Even if I unequip that. 45. Wow. Well, I guess I could unequip that. I mean, all it's giving me is extra critical damage. I'll re-equip it if I play an assassin. But I can equip that and give me more critical chance. Is that enough? Yep. That is exactly enough. Wow. Dude just got slaughtered from full HP. Well, you know, it's not all easy. Okay. What was the other equipment I unlocked? Ooh, new bracers. Plus 10 gold bonus. Let's see, I would need 25 extra pounds. Well, you know, I have. I mean, I might as well go on ahead and unlock it, since I have almost exactly the right amount of gold. Okay. Oh, wait, that's right, I was going to go all vampirism this time around. Which means I wouldn't be able to use my Sky Sword. Well. I mean, I can't equip all Vampirism because I don't have the weight either. Or I don't have the endurance, rather. Alright, what are the lightest Vampirism items I have? Probably the helmet and the cape. Let's see, 35. Oh. I guess they're all 35. Alright, well, if I unequip that, then I could equip 3 of them, right? Alright, well, let's go ahead and equip that. Then we'll go with the helmet and the cape. And I guess that's it. Since I can't get anything else. If I'm going to use just one of them, I might as well use the armor. Alright, now let's go and mess with my runes a little bit. Equip that one. Already have that one equipped. If I had the money, I'd go ahead and buy that. Alright, so what am I losing by equipping Vampirism there? Oh, I'm losing the hover ability. I'm okay with that. Alright, so obviously I can't go full Vampirism like... You know, like I was planning, but I can get, yeah, 8 HP for every kill. I mean, I only have 40 hit points, but as long as I don't get hit, like, 3 times in a row, I should be pretty survivable. Once you get negative life if you equip all the vampire items? You know, I don't know. I've never had enough weight to equip that many. All right. So let's try things out. I mean, with my new Sky Sword, I should be doing pretty good in the damage department, too. I am indifferent towards clowns, says Bippo. Yeah, that kind of describes how I feel about clowns. Just indifference. So, as you can see, not only am I getting back hit points, I'm also adding to my max HP every time I kill something. So essentially, I'm getting 12 life back, at least until I hit my life cap. Oops. See, I just got hit for 13, and then I just killed 2 things and healed myself all the way back up. Ah, man, I walked right into those spikes. Alright, I still have my air dash, just not the hover. I'm gonna have to remember that I don't have that. And I have pretty good spells as well. I mean, I have a good spell, and I get mana back every time I destroy items. So, you know, I'm good in the magic department. Gotten better at doing this down slash too. I was pretty miserable at it during the first stream. Just takes a little time to get the timing exactly down. But you know, I can do multiple hits on enemies and bounce on their heads and stuff now. Alright, I'm going to do a little bit more of the castle before I head to the Maya, just to get my max HP up a little bit more. I mean, I'm already at 112, which is pretty good. Oh wait, I guess that's my max, since I did not add to my max HP when I killed that thing. Well, I can't hit this thing with my orbs, and I can't hit it with my sword. So I guess I'm just never going in that room again. Alright, so 112 max HP, and I get 12 hit points back every time I kill something. It's a pretty good combination. Ah, they bounced right back up to me. That's a shame. Made a pretty good sound though. It's like industrial music. Alright. I guess I could just go ahead and head to the Maya now that I'm at full or max HP. I'm going this way. F that eyeball room. F it right in the room. Alright, Maya. Let's see if I can last for more than 5 seconds here. Ah. Nope. By a doom trait. I don't like the Lich King or Queen class because I always forget I'm playing one and I end up lowering my max HP too much accidentally and dying in one hit. How long will the stream last? Oh, I figure until 9 o'clock. A good 2 hour stream or so. Alright, so yeah, Lich King and Queen, good in theory with a lot of vampirism, but not the best. Let's be a paladin. Good old fashioned. Wow, I didn't even get any gold that run. That's pretty pathetic. Alright, let's unequip all this vampirism stuff. Fun's fun, but it's time to be serious. Oh, wait. What do I get from that? Crit chance? Oh, I can't equip that. I mean, 10% gold bonus is pretty good. But is it worth losing the 11 magic I get from that and lowering my damage by 10? I don't know. Probably not. I'm just going to stick with what I have. Well, plus my nice fancy new sword. I have crit chance rather than... Okay. I have to do it that way if I want to use this sword. The sword with the paladin should be pretty good, since paladin has pretty good base damage. Yeah, my strength is 65, so it's not bad. What's the time? It's 8:30. Sorry. I need to think globally, not locally. So yeah, another half hour or so. I like how shiny the sword is. Aw, man. I want to fall down here. I don't know, I kind of like having the two vampirism runes equipped rather than one vampirism and the air dash, or the hover rather. I mean, the hover's nice, but I mean, getting 4 hit points back per kill without having to sacrifice any health, it's pretty good. I mean, 4 hit points is nothing to sneeze at. Kinda sucks that you can only equip one rune per item, though. I mean, there's so many good runes, and you're so limited in what you can do with them. Has anyone tried Muri? Just noticed it on Steam. It looks very much like those little DOS games. For instance, Duke Nukem 1. No, I haven't heard of Muri. M-U-R-I. Oops. Not familiar with it. Although, to be honest, I didn't really like the old 2D Duke Nukem games that much. I don't know. All of those old DOS platformers, I mean, they were cool for the time, I guess, since, I mean, basically, no PC game could do what Super Mario Brothers did until Commander King came along. And, I mean, Commander King was pretty... Keen was pretty limited. Wait. Why is my health on the bottom now instead of the top? It's weird. Is that a trait? Oh, dextrocardia. I just now noticed that. I mean, Commander Keen was okay, but you know, I had an NES at the time, so as a kid, I was like, well, I mean, Super Mario Brothers is still way better than this. Why would I play this when I can play Mario? And, you know, I didn't realize at the time that you know, PC users didn't have the options that NES players had. Kind of weird to think that there was a time when the consoles were, you know, just hands down better than the PC as far as games go. I mean, that's how it was for a pretty long time. Till Doom came along. Doom was, well, Wolfenstein, I guess, was really the game that changed everything. Because, you know, no console could do what Wolfenstein did. I mean, oops. Just look at the Super NES version of Wolfenstein 3D. I mean, not the 2D Wolfenstein. Just look at the SNES version of Wolfenstein 3D, and it's kind of a train wreck. Thought you had a Master System, or was it a Mega Drive, Duke? Well, it's called the Genesis in the U.S., but yeah, I had a Genesis / Mega Drive. Use the shield. I know I should, since I have... Aw, man. See, if I had two dashes equipped, I could actually get this fairy chest. No problem. Because you have to get it without jumping. And all I would have to do is drop down onto that ledge and just dash twice. Not gonna work. Yeah, I mean, if you're into RPGs, then yeah, the PC was definitely the way to go. At least until the 16-bit era. Then consoles kind of came into their own as far as RPGs go. But yeah, I don't like using my shield because, like, crap. I don't pay attention to my mana well enough to know if it's actually going to be effective or not. Alright, I think I'm going to lock this place down and get that fairy chest. Because I know I'll be able to if I have two dashes equipped. Yeah, I'll be a Hokage. Why not? Alright, pretty good amount of money here. What was that other item? Oh yeah, the bracers that I bought that I can't use. Ooh, I should upgrade my equipment, so I might be able to actually use some of that stuff. There we go, 870, and I'll upgrade my health. I haven't upgraded my health in a while. Still can't use this, though. Nope. I mean, it is a decrease in damage, so I don't know if it would really be worth it. 113, though. Good God. Replace the double jump if possible. Yeah, that was my plan. Yeah, here we go. Replace that with that. So now I can no longer double jump, but I can do that. I don't usually lock the dungeon down just to get a fairy chest, but when it's one like that that I know I'll be able to get, I usually go for it. Like if it's a challenge room that I can't do because I just suck, then I usually won't make another attempt. Alright, so I need to go right, up, left. Oh wait, no, right, up, left. Okay, well, I'll figure it out. I see why people like the secret class. Oh, I don't have the secret class, so I cannot comment. Oh wait, I guess the secret class is whatever that, the bestiality thing is, right? How much was that? That was like 5,000 gold, wasn't it? It'll be a while before I can unlock that. God, I love doing 113 damage in one hit. Alright, I'll leave that there in case I need to get some health. Alright, need to remember I cannot double jump. It's an important thing to remember. Woo! Why did I do that? That was a lot of damage. Jesus Christ. I think I want to go back for the health. Alright, gotta be kind of careful. I mean, the Hokage is kind of a glass cannon. He does a lot of damage. But, cannot take that many hits. Also, the Hokage is really fast, so you have to be a little careful about that as well. Aw, man. Fudge. God damn it. Okay. Let's try that again. Spell sword, archmage. The archmage is kind of cool. I haven't been him yet, so I'll do that. God, that was pathetic. The archmage's ability is he can cycle through his spells. So instead of being stuck with a scythe, I can get that or that. Well, those are my only options. But it's helpful to have a lot of spell options for when you do come across the fairy rooms. Because there are a lot of challenge rooms that you can only do if you, you know what? Oops, I did not mean to do that. I don't know why I didn't just do this to begin with. Well, I mean, I know why, because I'm dumb, but, you know. Right. Not even going for those boxes, no reason to. The fireball circle, you can activate and then deactivate to save mana. Oops. Well, that did work well until the part where I got hit by the ninja star for no reason. And I'm already almost dead. Oh wait, crap, I went the wrong way. I'm sure that beep is someone in the chat room saying, "Duke, you're dumb, you went the wrong way." But you know, I don't have a way to finish that sentence. No. Alright, here we go. I think I can get across there in two dashes. I actually don't know, looking at it now. Oh, okay. I am probably never going to use a curse rune in my life. Oh yeah, it's boxing. That's what Kosho told me. I forgot it's supposed to be boxing. Gotta remember my lexicography. Fuck the last boss so hard, says Mors Draconis. Well, I will probably agree with you once I get there. Splunket. I guess I haven't been the minor Splunker character yet, so I might as well. Yeah, the curse runes, they make the game harder, but it says greater rewards, so I'm assuming more money. I don't really know. Alright, I'm going to equip my double jump back. Welcome, Armenza222. Wow, I don't have a lot of hit points. The Miner and the Spelunker, like Jestrop said, they're good characters to play if you want to be very careful. If that's your playstyle, then that's a good character to use. Aw, man. I went the worst possible way I could have gone. That's a lot of fireballs. So yeah, what's my gold percentage up now? Each gold drop is 40% more valuable. Wow. That is really good. What's a headlamp do? Not much. How fast does it drain mana? Pretty fast. I mean, I'm assuming that's useful in the dungeon, because I don't know why else you would have it. Although the flavor text did make it sound like the headlamp is completely useless, which is kind of a bummer. I think the Spelunker should their special ability should be, you make chests spawn or something. I don't know. Something related to getting money. I don't know what the deal with those red chests on the map are. Oh, I guess those are just normal chests. Oh yeah, unopened chest, okay. For some reason, I thought there was a special kind of chest that, a special kind of chest that stayed on the map even when you use the architect, but I guess not. Oh, I didn't even really take that much damage in that room. Oh, does the spunker see everything on the map? Is that their other ability? Okay. Well, I guess that's better than nothing. You know, that's why all those icons are already there. So I can actually see where the fairy chests are. That's kind of cool. I've never gotten the three chest minigame as a spelunker. Yeah, that would be pretty useful if you can actually find the right chest. So yeah, I'm not really playing with any specific goal in mind right now. Like, I wouldn't want to fight the boss as a spelunker. Oh god. The boss of level 3. Well, I guess that was a pretty good amount of gold. Whew. Alright. Another blood item. There's way more blood items than I'm ever going to actually equip at once. I don't know if there's a minimum to your health or not. I don't know what would actually happen if you tried equipping so many of those that your health would be zero or less. I guess once I actually have enough weight, enough endurance to try it out, I'll see what happens. Aw, man, I dodged all the bones, but I got hit by the stupid fire eye. I'm in the money, cause I'm a spelunker. Well, I guess I should see what that fairy chest down there is before I head into the Maya. Actually, there's a lot of chests over to the left as well. Wait. What room is that chest in? Right. Oh, wait. You can't see my mouse cursor. Is that in the room I went through, or is that in the room below it? It's hard to tell. Let's go back down there and see what's what. Oh, I guess I didn't explore this whole room. Yep. It's in this room. Okay. Man, do more chests spawn or something? It seems like there's way more chests as well. If that's the case, that would be pretty good. Yeah, if that is a thing it doesn't say. Maybe it just seems like there's more chests because I can actually see all of them at once. But in reality, it's the same number of chests. It always is. See what that question mark is too. Might be something good. Might be a mini game. Oh wait, these are just boss chests, I guess. Looks like YouTube might become a useless place to go now. Why do you say that? I got the freakout bug again. I don't know what triggers that. Seems like it happens when I get... Oh, you know what? It might be caused by the non-stereoscopic train. I did hear someone say that causes it to glitch sometimes. YouTube peeps that are making money off video game videos are getting destroyed by copyright infringement suits from game companies now. That's what I heard, that they were getting a lot of flag stuff. But I heard that it wasn't even the game companies that were flagging things. I heard it was like third parties that don't have anything to do with the content. And I figured it was just something on YouTube's end that was messing up. That would suck if it actually is the game companies. I mean, there was a while there that Nintendo was flagging Let's Plays and stuff, just of Nintendo games, and there was a pretty big outcry against it, and they reversed the policy. So I imagine it wouldn't be very good for a company's public image to do that sort of thing. Then again, if they're all doing it, I guess there's not much people can say about it. Oh, this is fun. It's a random teleporter. At least I assume it's random. The few times I used it, it seemed to just throw me to a random point in the map. Whew. Well, there is a chest here, so hopefully this will be worth it. I mean, I could just open the chest and run out, but where's the fun in that? I think LPs on YouTube are like a number one marketing tool for video games. Yeah, exactly. I mean, there are LPers out there with, you know, millions of subscribers. Wow. I mean, I should be able to do this with just one dash, I think. Just got to, ooh. Yeah, there we go. Sprint rune, another one. So I can equip 3 sprint runes now, if I wanted to. It's pretty good. And streamers, but fuck them, apparently. Well, you know, the only streamers that matter are the ones who stream League of Legends and StarCraft. Not even StarCraft that much these days. Mostly just League of Legends. Hmm. I mean, there's a couple fairy chests over there if I want to venture into the forest. Actually, probably my best move right now is to just stick to the castle. Because I'm getting a shitload of gold. Just from, you know, normal stuff. So I'm going to explore the castle to the fullest before I go anywhere else. I mean, I was going to say, there's no reason to go into the forest. I should just... Ah, crap. I should just go into the Maya. But, I mean, I should maximize my gold gain in this run, if at all possible. I think this will be the last one, though. It's creeping up on 9 o'clock here. I'm never going to buy Gone Home because I watched an LP of it. Pretty much zero reason to play that. Well, I mean, Gone Home... I mean, I wanted to play Gone Home, so I specifically didn't watch an LP of it. So I would not spoil myself. I mean, there are certain games where people will watch an LP instead of buying the game. But I mean, I don't think those people would have bought the game anyway, though. I think it's the same argument as piracy, honestly. I mean, the only people, I mean, like me, I wanted to play Gone Home, so I didn't watch an LP of it. The only people who would watch an LP instead of buying the game are people who wouldn't have bought the game anyway. But I mean, I understand how for a game developer, that can, not necessarily the most compelling reason to allow people to LP your game. It's kind of funny, the, Vlambeer, the guys who made Nuclear Throne, they encourage people to stream and LP their game as much as possible. And they even have a, they have a form on their website, an automated form, where you enter your YouTube username, and it generates a letter saying, "We, Vlambeer, give such and such permission to stream, record videos of our games as much as they want." which is really damn cool. If anyone does flag your stuff, like, falsely. Because, I mean, you know, third-party companies are trying to flag stuff all the time that they don't have the rights to. Just because of, or, I mean, I guess it's just automatically matching the content. But with Lambeer, if you do run into something like that, then you can just fill out that form and say, "Here, YouTube, I have explicit permission to stream this from the developers of this game, so that flag on my video is bullshit." But, you know, different game companies or different developers and publishers have different attitudes about that kind of stuff, I guess. Two chests. Oh, it's boss room, that's why. It's kind of disappointing that you can't fight the bosses again. I was kind of hoping I could do boss runs and beef my gold up a little bit. Well, I do too, but I didn't want to pay $15 for it. It says Morris. Well, I mean, you know, I bought it on sale. But based on what I hear that game is, I don't think $15 is a totally unfair price. Alright, see you later, Morris. Oh, Aegis Dragon, welcome. Alright. Go down here if I want to get to that fairy chest. Ah! Defeat all enemies. Well, that should be doable. Oh, these are the guys that fling you all the way across the level when you hit. Well, no, I guess they're the same ones. Ooh. Ah! Ah! Oh, crap. Wow, that did a lot of damage. Alright, well, that went okay. I'm gonna spend some money, then I'm out of here, I guess. Ooh, assassin. I think I'll be the Splunker, Splunkette again. That went pretty well last time. Ooh, can I afford? I can. I'll take all my money though. Jesus. Well, I mean, I have enough money, so I don't know when this opportunity will come by again. So I'm gonna go for it. The Lost Art of the Dragons. That you cannot jump? You cannot jump. You have unlimited flight and can cast four powerful fireballs at your foes. Wow. Huh. Alright. Well, that should be pretty interesting the next time I stream. Press A to awesome. I guess that's pretty much the whole skill tree then. I have unlocked. Well, unless something else pops up when I unlock that, which it looks like it might. Sorry, what did you buy for $15, dude? Well, Gone Home, I bought on sale, so I got it for $5 instead of $15. But I probably would have paid $15 for that game eventually. Alright, well, this has been a pretty successful stream, I think. Fought a boss, got a lot accomplished, had a couple good runs, had a couple not so good runs. It's kind of the nature of these sorts of games. So yeah, thanks for watching. Don't know when the next stream will be, but watch the Twitter and Facebook and stuff for updates. And yeah, see you guys next time. Thanks for coming out. Bye.